Harbor. We're back in Far Harbor. Hello, lifeforms. It is I, Bonsai, and in case you haven't noticed, we're back in Far Harbor. We're about to do a quest. It's a side quest over here, and it starts with this individual, Pearl.
Are you a detective I heard about?
I am. Let's see. Yeah.
Oh, wonderful. I wasn't sure how I was ever going to find you.
Sounds like we may have another case on our hands.
I haven't been able to find any of the local police force. The lads. We may have a murder on our hands, and we need an outside set of eyes.
I think she's malfunctioning, but I'll roll with it.
Where did the crime take place?
At the Cliff's Edge Hotel, just north of the town. Will you help us solve this heinous crime?
Who's the victim?
I really should.
Oh.
Not here, where there might be paparazzi.
Yeah, she's malfunctioning. Okay, that's it. When we get to the hotel, if everything's clear, I'm switching back over to my charisma gear. That's Reginald's suit and the pompadour wig and the black rim glasses. But let's see. Oh, good. No pests this time. I love this robot. This Robibot is hilarious. As you can see, I've actually ditched my turtle suit. I think I'm gonna be enjoying this Shield of Acadia a bit too much. Yeah, it's got better armor and it's a little bit lighter, and I like the stats on it. The stat boosts, anyway. Okay. I've been to the Cliff's Edge Hotel before, but... I'm gonna ignore that. I already know where it's from. So far, okay, that's getting annoying. Anyway, as I was trying to say, all the different quests for Far Harbor have been pretty interesting. This one in particular I really like, and if you're not reliant on the Idiot Savant perk, I highly recommend getting this, because there are two items in here that will quickly help you speed through leveling. I'll show you when we get there.
What do you mean, the other people? patrons are rowdy.
I had not been in this part of the hotel for some time. Perhaps there is some sort of sporting event that has them agitated. Several of them tried to grab me and, well, their clothing was certainly not suitable for polite company. Shall we be off?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, yeah. Let's see, the pompadour wig. For right now, now that I'm thinking about it, I'm switching back over to the armored, battered fedora. Holy shnikey. That's fine. I've been itching to swing my hammer all day. Big stupid warhammer right in your face. Whoa, you missed me. You didn't miss me, though. Always get the block wrong. Die. Nimble Institute rifle. That's certainly useless, but hey, I could use the 5mm anyway. I always hate fighting ghouls. I never can block them right. Huh. Well, that was probably a fluke more than anything. Holy crap, I hit him so hard he disappeared from the world. Gosh, I guess I don't know my own strength. Can I go up this way? Yes, I can. Dirt, 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 dirt. Gangrenous feral ghouls have poisoned attacks, so be extra careful against them. Yeah, you can tell when you're poisoned by the green tint on your skin. Okay. And if you want to speed things along after you do... Whoa! Excuse me, I was trying to explain something here. Haha, you missed me. Didn't miss me that time. Disarmed. Mm-hmm. Boom shakalaka. Well, what's this? Lucky Nux. Critical shots do double damage, and the critical hit meter fills 15% faster. And it's got the puncturing mod on it. I don't know about you, but being punched by a pair of brass knuckles, I think, would hurt like I don't know what. But as I was trying to say, when you're going into VATS, after you make the kill, press the circle button or the Xbox equivalent, and you'll break out. That can often save your life. Like that. Sit down, kid. Uh-oh. Nick's in trouble. I got your back, homie. And I got your loot, so there. Oh, there you are. Cool. Oh, a glowing one. Okay, getting overwhelmed here. As long as this glowing one is around, the others are gonna get a buff. I think they actually heal when there's a glowing one around. I know a glowing one can revive, but... Trying to backhand me, are you? Nope, not today. Aid, let's see. Alright. Deathclaw steak would be nice because I could use some extra action points and regen. I'll take the blood steak. Definitely need more HP for right now. Mutant hound chops, yes. All of those. Those remove radiation, so I could definitely use more of those. Who'd have thought that that could remove radiation? I'll take that. Nope, I don't think so either, Nick. Okay. They all died running towards something. Hold on a second. Alright, that's better. Are those things out of ammo? Probably are. It seems like every DLC for every Fallout game has to have at least one. Okay. And I thought I liked to make a splashy entrance. Well done, Nick. But like I was saying, it seems like every DLC has to have at least one vault. Because I can understand that. I mean, vaults are like the prime inside the Fallout universe. I mean, everything revolves around Vault-Tec, almost. Yeah. Let me finish ratting this place for junk. And I always need more 5mm rounds. Speaking of which, hold on just a second. No, I don't. I have no levels in Scrounger. I really need to start taking Scrounger. That way I can start finding more and more ammunition for my minigun. Let's see, but... I'm gonna take one level in luck for right now. That way, next level, I can start taking Scrounger. For right now, though... Well, we came here to do a job. We might as well do it. Open sesame. That's not exactly, your home away from home underground. Bad sell. Alright. Now that we are at a safe, place. Black rim glasses. Pompadour wig. And Reginald's suit. I'm gonna need all of this. This place just got a little more interesting. Yeah, you're telling me. I wish I could take that little backpack off. And I wish I could take the bag off the postman's outfit and make it turn it into a police officer's uniform. Okay.
What happened? Who died?
It's Mr. Parker, the primary owner and financier for the hotel. This is just a disaster.
Okay, if you're not going to get out of my way...
Don't they realize that they're going to disturb the evidence? You'd better come with me.
And I shall return to my workstation and allow you.
Yeah, get out of here. There are clues to be found, and you'll get your stinking DNA all over.
Have a look at the crime scene for clues.
Well,
already we can discuss your plan. You are free to question the residents, but their safety is our priority. So unless you have solid evidence, I would avoid accusations.
That's a hint, by the way. Anyway,
is this blood?
I don't think there's been any blood in this dude for a very, very long time.
Looks like the brain enclosure was smashed.
Now this is a very nice weapon, the Fence Buster. Ignores 30% of your opponent's armor. I imagine if you add nails to it, then armor would be almost non-existent in comparison to most enemies.
What is this doing here?
I like how even when you're in first person, your lips still move when you're going through dialogue. Anyway. Maxwell.
Was there anything else?
Your residents are robots.
Not robots, Detective. Well, not exactly, anyway.
I believe the term they use is robo-brain. Back before the war, the residents decided the best way to wait it out was to put their brains inside robotic chassis.
Was there anything else?
Tell me about the victim.
Mr. Ezra Parker was the primary owner and financier for the hotel.
Yeah, you already said that.
Experience managing venture projects around the world.
Mm-hmm.
It's an idea to have our premier clients become investors in the vault section of the hotel. He worked with Vault Tech to have this built to their every specification. Was there anything else?
I found the murder weapon.
I found the murder weapon.
You don't think he could be involved, do you? I can't imagine him ever doing such a thing.
Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here should you need me.
Okay, it's from a movie set. Okay. All right, let's question the people. Concierge, he can't help me. He reminds me of Eddie from Fallout New Vegas. He doesn't complain, he doesn't judge, he just beeps. Well, this is fancy. Anybody fancy some Kims? I'm a buff tats guy myself, because it makes me feel strong and smirt. Okay.
You think I'm stupid? I saw the way he looked at you. You gonna tell me that's nothing?
It wasn't like that. We were friends. He helped me out of a tight spot or two is all.
I couldn't stand by like some pasty-faced Percy while he put the moves on my best girl.
But now the law is on our tail. What are we going to do?
Come with me. Let's leave this dark hole of a city behind. We can be in Buenos Aires by tomorrow.
Oh, I want to believe you, I do, but they'll never let us go.
Then we'll make our stand here. I've got a gun for each of us.
No. The line is, then we'll make our stand here. Two lovers together with a bullet for each of them.
God, why can't I ever get that line? Forget it. I can't do this right now.
Okay, how long have you been doing this scene? And you still haven't gotten it?
How can I help? Is there a question about the kids?
How did you know? Let's see,
did you have any thoughts about the murder?
Santiago. He keeps going back to look at the crime scene.
Really?
I found your baseball bat at the crime scene. Care to explain how it got there?
Someone is clearly trying to frame me for the murder. It's probably Santiago. You saw him skulking around the crime scene.
What were you and Gilda talking about when I walked in?
Oh, we were just rehearsing a scene. Nothing to worry about.
Maybe later.
Okay. Just let me know how I can help.
Alright, let's see. Where did the other RoboBrain go? Hey, check this out. Beefcake! Beefcake! Yeah, as if that's gonna help. This seems a bit too clean, even for Vault-Tec. Hey, I think Nick can be in the movies, don't you? Alright. Let's see. Whose room is this? Ah! This is the room I was looking for. Let's see. The pirate hat and... Yep. The road goggles. Ah! Crap! And why I was looking for that is... Wait a minute. Charisma? Oh, shoot. Oh, well. At least the road goggles help. The road goggles increase your intelligence by 1. And that, in turn, for every action that you take, increases your XP you get by 3%. What the heck is that? Probably doesn't matter. What I don't understand is, how is it that a Chinese sword is better than the revolutionary sword, huh? How? Because, let's face it, if you want anything, if you, especially good steel, you go American. At least that's just something I've always believed in. Okay, was this the overseer's office? Must have been.
Yes.
I'll be taking that. Alright. Let's see. Let's go talk to... Santiago. I think is his name. Good catch there.
Tell me, what does this piece say to you?
It's about composition.
It's about composition. Balance of colors and emotions, and the struggle to maintain internal order.
Indeed, this was the last piece I did in a series of portraits of Gilda, number 1378. Her emotional landscape is superimposed on the portrait. The reality of the subject is distorted as the ego attempts to project itself this way.
You're a Hillary Clinton supporter, aren't you?
What does this one say?
Because you're spewing a whole bunch of crap and nothing makes any sense.
It looks like trees in space. Maybe it's about the struggle to maintain life adrift. In an empty void?
I don't think this guy's the murderer because he's too dumb to murder anybody. It's a picture I put up in all my settlements.
It's cute, I guess. Some people like that kind of thing.
More than you would imagine. Truth be told, this is my best-selling piece. I did this series under a pseudonym, of course.
Of course. Anyway, can we talk about the case?
My fellow connoisseur of the art, here to see my latest work.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
The person you should be looking at is Juliana Riggs. That Philistine would not know art from her own excrement. She and Ezra had a rather dramatic fight recently.
Juliana and Ezra are arguing about.
I don't know. I was painting at the time and I was trying to block it out. Though my bad gait probably hurt them. Maybe you should check with her.
Never mind.
Okay, I've got lots and lots of choices here. One question turns into another. Every answer, more questions. And this is remarkably run down. Makes me think that Vault-Tec was up to something sinister. Hi. Here, let's go back upstairs. Just because I'm curious. Looks like they went half-assed on this. Like they ran out of funds midway through construction. Alright. Okay, there was one other hallway down here. Overseer! Overseer's office. Fun. Something tells me I'm not gonna get my Vault 118 jumpsuit to complete my collection. I don't know, it's just a bad feeling. Really. Be funny if I found Mentats and whiskey together. Alright, just for fun, let's take a look at this. Vault 118. Overseer instructions. Confidential, confidential, confidential. Overseer's eyes only. Violation VTP 01011. Vault 118 is designed to test the social interaction between the working class and the ultra-wealthy when under confined conditions, working in conjunction with the staff and the Cliff's Edge Hotel. This vault shall function as a luxury hotel to attract the necessary testing subjects. Upon beginning the tests, additional subjects shall be admitted from the local population into a second, much inferior wing of the vault. So it's just to let snobs be snobs and the blue collars be stepped on and have the so-called betters look down at them from the long nose that they possess. Yes. Operation Protocol Manual. Residential admittance. Prior to experiment activation, Vault 188 shall function as the ultra-elite hotel to attract test subjects of appropriate wealth and status. This shall be operated as the clandestine area of the hotel to ensure that individuals draw to privilege and exclusivity. Is that even a word, exclusivity, or present? Upon activation notice from Vault-Tec, the secondary wing of the vault shall be made open to the public and selected from the local working-class population. These subjects are to be taken through exclusive areas of the vault on entry, but therefore confined to cramped second wing. Shouldn't it be the cramped second wing? Once residents have been admitted, the vault is to be sealed until test results can be determined. Preferential treatment. This subject group, not to number more than 10, shall have their every desire attended to by robotic staff to the extent that it is possible. They are considered to be above all legal restrictions when interacting with test group B. That explains all the robots downstairs. Test Group B is the working class. This subject group should begin numbering 300 and shall be restricted to the second wing of the vault. Measures should be taken to ensure that living conditions are uncomfortable and cramped. Food and other rations are to be extremely limited, and any breach of the rules are to be judged by Test Group A and enacted by robotic staff members. That's a rebellion waiting to happen. Staff duties and security. Due to the potential for extreme social interaction, Vault-Tec staff shall be restricted to the overseer and key research members. All other security services and maintenance positions shall be filled by robotic staff to ensure safety and test compliance. Alright, Overseer's Log. Change of testing parameters. This is completely unheard of. One of the subjects from the test group A is apparently a researcher for General Atomics on some sort of advanced robotics program. He and his wife have convinced the other members of Group A that with the international situation becoming tense once again, their best chance to outlast the war is to have their brains inserted into these robots. And they're doing this voluntarily. It's absolutely insane. I've tried to convince my superiors that this will completely discount the test results, but they seem more intrigued by the idea than appalled. The door wouldn't open. We received the activation notice from Vault-Tec to begin the test, despite the second wing still being incomplete. However, when I attempted to trigger the recruitment protocol for Test Group B, the system informed me that I had been locked out. Someone from Test Group A seems to have overridden the system to prevent the admittance of the local population of the island. They've been pounding on the door for days, and there is nothing I can do. Sorry about that. I tripped over my tongue there for a second. All right. I can't take this. Oh God, it's been weeks, and now I realize today that I've been the test subject. Instead of testing the social interaction between the locals and this group of rich assholes, it's just me trapped in here with them. They're going to live forever, and I have to deal with them for the rest of my life. I can't take it! Okay. Play tape.
Progress on construction of the second wing of the vault is completely stalled. Once the premier area of the vault had been completed, funding seems to have been cut off. My supervisors informed me that they haven't received payment from Mr. Parker, and Vault-Tec won't pay out of pocket to continue construction. I've repeatedly approached Ezra about the finances, but he keeps telling me that Mrs. Riggs hasn't transferred the funds. However, when I asked her, Juliana said that she had just given Ezra extra for the gold paint in the rooms. I've hired an investigator to look for signs of embezzlement in a few weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds like Israel is embezzling from his investors.
So Ezra, the murder victim, was embezzling. He is the murder victim, right? Yeah, he is. Alright. And two women were arguing with one another. Alright, I've already talked to him. Seriously? I think their brains have been in those jars a bit too long. Yes.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
If you ask me, it's one of those actors. Or that horrible painter. Their type is always the cause of violence.
Okay.
I heard you had a big fight with Ezra a few days ago. Care to explain?
Oh, well, it wasn't that big a deal, really. He wanted more money to pay for repairs on the hotel. I wasn't feeling well that day and lashed out at it.
I found some evidence that Ezra was embezzling from you and the other investors.
Oh, well, I really didn't believe that. Mr. Parker wouldn't do such a thing, I'm sure.
What's with all the junk in here?
These are our things. We're just waiting till the war blows over so we can bring them back to mansion.
Maybe later.
Okay, I keep going back to that Joker. Was this... That must have been part of the so-called second wing. Aha! Here's someone I haven't talked to yet.
You're not so bad yourself.
Before all this, red hair that was the envy of every girl on Lex for days, darling. I'm sure you'd rather hear some of my stories from the silver screen rather than talk about that nasty murder business.
Sure, why not?
You're quite the actor.
What can I say? It just comes naturally. Surely you must be here for my salacious stories of the silver screen.
Have you ever done radio? Your voice is quite enchanting.
Well, darling, play your cards right. Maybe I'll whisper some sweet nothings in your ear. Care to hear some of my stories, Detective?
I've never done this before.
I must say.
This is funny. Okay, how can we do that? Oh, this is hilarious. Oh, what? Alright, what happened? Did the game crash? What happened? Nick? You were supposed to be my partner! I think I've been violated! The doctor on the Pridwin? Remember one of his questions? Have you ever had sex with something that isn't human? No, sir! You didn't see that. It didn't happen. Okay. Yeah, I need to have my memory wiped, thank you. Oh, that was nasty.
I heard that Julian Ezra had an argument a few days before he was found dead.
Tell me about that.
So she handles all the money, and Ezra was embellishing.
Have you noticed Juliana acting strangely lately?
Oh, well, I'm probably just being paranoid, but she's been so much more pleasant lately. I mean, it's been nice, but also...
That was pleasant? Yeah, she is. Something's funny about the missus. Let us see. Where ain't ya? You handle all the money, and you are having money problems, so I think you killed him.
Ezra was embezzling your money. That's why you killed him and framed Keith.
You were so close, Detective.
It's a shame. I thought I could keep the ruse going a little longer. Well, had to end eventually, I suppose. This doesn't have to end in more violence, Detective. Just walk away. I'll leave, and you can tell them I escaped.
Not a chance. Your murder spree stops here.
Then let us end this.
Yeah, get him, Nick. Before I do that, let's see, the Ushanka hat and the road goggles will increase my intellect and make me look extra ridiculous while doing it.
Hey, now see what I can do.
I found the killer.
It was Ezra. He killed Juliana and took her place to hide his tracks.
My word. I never thought Mr. Parker was capable of something like this. What happened when you confronted him?
You were right there when I confronted him.
He attacked.
One moment, please. I got a call. Hello?
I don't think we could have done it without you.
No, afraid not. All right, oh, bye. And that, ladies and gentlemen, was Brain Dead. And that tells you how to get a rare pirate captain's hat and a rare pair of road goggles for a little extra XP for when you turn in your quests. Completed Brain Dead Part 2. Huh, I didn't even know there was a Brain Dead Part 2. Anyway, let's see. Where is a good place to end this? A good dramatic place to end it. Nope, 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 nope. And a whole lot of nope. There sure are a lot of Securitrons around here, though. I know the perfect place to end this. If I can just find it. Ah, here it is. Here it is. Well, I hope you enjoyed this bonus episode of my playthrough of Far Harbor. It's called Brain Dead. And if you liked it and you want to see more of my playthroughs of Far Harbor and the other Fallout 4 DLCs, you can check it out on my YouTube page. My YouTube name is the same as it is on Twitch, Steam, and the PlayStation Network. It's Bonsai0311. And if you do have a particular game you want to see me play, or if you have any suggestions, or if you just would like to make me a friend, send me a friend request, or send me your ideas on the future of my channel, I'd love to hear from you, and I'd also love to find new people to play games with. Anyway, until next time, like, link, subscribe, do the whole social thing. And as always, I will see you in the next playthrough. Later.